Hi, welcome to the Dynamics tutorials. So in this case we're going to look at normal and tangential coordinates, but we'll have a radius of curvature that's changing. So here's our curve that our particle is moving along, so y is equal to 0.25 times x squared. There's the x-axis, the y-axis, and then the origin fixed point. And so this establishes a set of coordinates so that we have a tangential direction here that's going tangent along the path, so let's label that t, and then a normal direction that's going in this direction that's going in towards the radius of curvature of the path. We want to find the velocity, the vector velocity of the particle. And then we also want to find just the magnitude of the acceleration, but we don't have to find its direction. So first off, if we're going to find velocity, we have a speed of 10 meters per second, but we don't have a direction. So if we think about the tangent as being aligned with the tangential direction, then we can think about this angle theta then, and this angle theta is going to be in this little triangle where this is dy and this side over here is dx. So if we do dy over dx and go ahead and use this function and get that derivative, that'll be the 2 that's up here will come down and sit here, so it'll be 2 times 0.25 times x. We're looking at x is equal to 5 meters, so we plug in the 5 there. And then for our dy dx, we get 2.5. And remember, dy dx is unitless because it's a change in y over change in x. So it's a length over length. Then we can get our angle theta then as the inverse tangent of dy over dx, because we have dy over here, which is our opposite side, divided by dx, which is our adjacent side. So the inverse tangent then of 0.250 gets us 68.2 degrees. And then we can write velocity in terms of magnitude and direction. So velocity is 10 meters per second. And then show that it's, if this is theta over here, then this angle here must also be theta. So show that this angle here is 68.2 degrees. Or we could go ahead and show it in Cartesian coordinates by taking the magnitude, multiplying through by a unit vector going in that direction, and then we'd get this as our velocity. To do our acceleration, we need normal and tangential coordinates components. So we have our tangential is just the rate of change of the velocity. So at is the 1 meter per second squared that we were given in the problem statement. But to get the normal acceleration, that's going to be v squared divided by the radius of curvature. So we've got our first derivative. We need to get our second derivative. So come back up here. Second derivative would just leave you with the 0.5. So it'll be 0.5. When you take your second derivative, it's how the first derivative, which is unitless, changes with respect to x, which has length units. So your second derivative has units of 1 over length in this case. Plug it into your radius of curvature formula, 1 plus first derivative squared, that whole quantity to the 3 halves divided by the absolute value of the second derivative. Plug in all your numbers and you get 39.04 meters for the radius of curvature. Now you can plug in and solve for the normal component of the acceleration. It'll be v squared divided by radius of curvature. V was given in the problem statement, radius curvature we just calculated, and we get 2.56 meters per second squared. And again, we don't have to do direction for what we were asked for here, just the magnitude. So the magnitude is just the at squared, which is the 1 meter per second, plus the an squared, 2.56 meters per second squared. Add those together, take a square root, and you get the 2.75 meters per second squared. Thanks for watching.